Dear student, upon Westminster Bridge, this poem by William Wordsworth has been divided into three stanzas. Now let's begin detailed analysis of the poem stanza-wise. See stanza number one. Earth has not anything to show more fair. Dull would be of soul who could pass by a sight so touching in its majesty. Dear student, here William Wordsworth woke up early in the morning. As it is a down time before sun rise only, he went there. At Westminster Bridge, you can see in the image only student, when he stood near Westminster Bridge, he was thrilled. When he stood at Westminster Bridge, as he's traveling over the Westminster Bridge early morning, and when he stopped to admire the view, inspired, he described the beauty in front of him in the poem. Here, William Wordsworth says, there could be more beautiful, there could not be more beautiful scene on this earth more than in front of him. Only someone who is very dull would ignore such splendid sight. Dear student, he was really thrilled, amazed, observing beauty of the bridge. As William Wordsworth explained, that the city is very quiet because still daily routine has not started. The city is still silent, very quiet, not awake, and seems to sparkle in the clean early morning air. It is as if the city of London is covered by the morning beauty as a garment. Students, see here now words. More fair means more beautiful. Majesty, it means royal style. Dull would be the soul. Dull means that it's inactive person, passive person. Student, here Westminster Bridge, it was built in November 1750. It is around 85 feet bridge and length is 250 meters, student. So poet here describes the beauty of the bridge. Second sentence, student, dull would be the soul who could pass by. This is example of inversion, because words are not organized in proper and logical sequence. As poet explained, the title itself here, Upon Westminster Bridge. Speaker here takes in the city, its natural surroundings, sees him both separate and unified by comparing to the natural world that surrounds it. The poem emphasizes the challenge of locating a clear border between the two. The poem arguably goes so far as to suggest that there isn't one, that the city itself is an extension of nature. Student, so in first stanza, poet describes the splendid beauty that hardly anyone could ignore. He is really surprised to see that city has taken the garment. So here, poet want to narrate in second stanza, student. The city has now does like a garment wear the beauty of the morning silent bear. Ships, towers, domes, theatres and temples lie upon unto the fields and to the sky, all bright and glittering in the smokeless air. See now meaning of the second stanza. Student, when William Wordsworth stood at the edge of the bridge, Westminster Bridge, and it was built by Thomas Page in November 1750, between 1862. And now he's really enthralled and surprised that city is looking like a, having a garment, that silent hour of sunrise. Even man-made structures, shape, towers, domes, temples and theaters, all are shining clear. When sun rose, these structures are visible. Shapes, towers, domes, temple, theater. As the air is yet unpolluted, because London hasn't started their regular routine. Vehicles, companies, industries. So poet want to tell, it is still unpolluted, crystal clean beauty, pristine beauty of early morning. Poet describes the beauty early morning sun shining, its rays on valley and hill and rock too. Never had the poet seen such a stunning sight as this, or felt such deep peace. So here is a simile in the first sentence of the second stanza. City is like, does like a garment wear. So poet is comparing how cities look like a person who is having a garment. Even this is personification. City cannot wear garment. So city is personified. Actually, we use garment, human beings usually. So human beings' qualities transferred to non-living thing. So that is personification. So all bright and glittering in the smokeless air. Smokeless air. Student, this sentence represent how after industrialization, after industrial revolution in England, factories, companies started. And now air is with smoke only. Gases are there. Polluted air. But now, early in the morning, London gates, glittering and smokeless air. And all these monuments, ships, dome, theaters are clearly visible. And so, poet observe the rising of the sun from behind from the mountain. And so, it looks so pleasant, so serene beauty, so silent beauty. Poet really appreciate and enjoys. This last stanza, student, third stanza. Never did sun more beautifully steep in his first splendor valley, rock or hill. Never saw I, never felt a calm so deep, the river guilt at his own sweet will. Dear God, the very houses seemed asleep, and all that mighty heart is lying still. See, student, now last stanza also having plenty of personification and inversion explained by the poet. Poet here now explain, never did sun more beautifully steep. Steep means cover. Never saw I felt the calm and so deep. Never before I have enjoyed silence, calmness. Here poet describes here the beauty of sunshine, and even the river Thames glided on slowly under the bridge. The people in their houses are asleep yet. People are sleepy yet, they are not awake. They are still taking rest, and collectively their hearts rest quiet. The river Thames glided on slowly under the bridge. Glided, flowing. The people in their houses are asleep yet, and collectively their hearts rest quiet. Student, here mighty heart. Mighty means collectively to the heart of all people of London city. Now see, personification here, student. Sun more beautifully steep. Steep means cover. Covering quality belongs to human beings applies to non-living. So, example of personification. Never saw I felt so calm, so deep. Here is inversion. Verb order is not followed, not maintained in proper or logical sequence. So, example of inversion. Next is again personification, student. The river guilt at the own sweet will. Sweet will not possible. So, again, human quality applies to the river, non-living thing. Now, next is metaphor. The houses seems asleep. Now, houses means houses are referred, compared with the people. As everyone, all the citizens of London are taking rest, they are still not awoken, and so it is example of metaphor. And last sentence, student, almighty hearts is lying still. Again, personification. Student, in this poem we get a lot of example of personification. Dear God, that the heart of the city still, the citizens are sleepy yet. City has not yet stirred, and its heart, the humans are sleeping, still unmoving. They haven't begun the day's bustle. The city is attributed with the human quality of having heart. City doesn't have heart, we have heart. So, having quality of heart is applies to city. So, student, this poem upon Westminster Bridge, narrated by William Wordsworth. This poem's first line that develop the connection between the city and the nature by describe the city itself as a natural feature on the earth. In fact, according to the speaker, the city is actually better looking than any other feature of the earth. And so to the point, at the sight of its touching, earth is a word that more strongly connotes the planet's green and blue wilderness than the image. The earth seems proud to slow, as in show of early morning London, as if the city wore its offspring. Student, here poet William Wordsworth, your speaker challenges perceived borders between nature and city. He want to explain man-made monuments and the natural beauty. How these physical things appears in natural beauty. And finally, student, the poem judges this mix of city and nature as somehow even better than pure nature. In fact, the city seems the ideal stage for contemplating the beauty of the morning, as the morning sunlight is somehow better appreciated when cast upon the waking city. Never did sun more beautifully stiff in its first splendor valley, rock or hill. The speaker says, rather than reveal the city's ugliness. Here, William Wordsworth used various different archaic words, meaning are explained there. Does means does, never means never, more fair means more beautiful, unto means to, steep means to saturate, to cover with, glide means to move smoothly or long, mighty heart means collectively to the hearts of the people of the London city. So, student, here are the more words explained by William Wordsworth. Let's see now example of figure of speech. Now, as I explain many figure of speech while giving detailed explanation, inversion, simile, personification, even exclamation is used there. So here is the chart is given, student. You can refer that dull would be soul who could pass by, example of inversion. And simile is there, student. The city does like a garment wear. And one more example of personification. Never did sun more beautifully stiff. And inversion, one more example. Never saw I never felt calm so deep, were order not followed. Dear God, now this is student exclamation. Exclamation is also considered as a figure of speech. So there are many figure of speech used in this poem. But William Wordsworth insisted on personification. There are four examples of personification, student. You can go through it. Here is the list of the lines of the poem which has personification. Here, student, now theme, rhythm, metaphor, let's see. Nature is the theme of the poem. London is not introduced in a negative aspect, but it is shown as a natural and scenery. As metaphor is also used by narrator, that cities, people, heart, collective heart is expressed there. Rhyme. There are few rhymings, student. Hill, will, still, example of rhymings. So, as this poem, it was published in 1807. It has octave and sestet in having a Petrarchan style. Student, basically this is a sonnet. So, this 14-line poem describes many things. As we know, William Wordsworth is famous for nature and romance. He is a romantic poet. And this poem has also other figure of speech like imagery. If you go through these three stanzas poem, definitely there are many images used by poet to describe the beauty of the city. London Bridge is there, earth, more fair is there, the sky is silent cities. So all these are the images. So I hope, student, you understood the poem in detail. You can repeat and watch as the stanza wise explanation is given in this video. Please subscribe and like the video to get latest update. Please hit the bell icon.